There are two kinds of people here today. Those who will miss blessing and those who will receive. And what are the things that can make you to lose a blessing? Number one, when you are asked to ask God for mercy, you say, it doesn't concern me. Number two, when you don't concentrate. There are some people, they come to church, immediately the message begins. Everybody around them is in trouble. They begin to talk to everybody around them about anything. And as they're distracting themselves, they don't want to enter the kingdom. They don't want anybody to enter. So they'll be distracting you. When such a person is by you, tell the person, please don't disturb me. You have the right. Number three, the second set of people that will miss blessings today in this service are the ones that within them they're saying, God, since I've been coming, have you done it? They're telling me you're going to do it today. You're going to do it. I don't believe that. You're not doing anything. These are the people. Don't think it's because of that mistake you made that will stop you from receiving, because God will wipe it away. What will stop you? These minor things I've mentioned. These minor things. So if you have that kind of mindset, change it and say, Father, I am number one that will receive. I am not in the group of people that will not receive. So the fourth reason why you will not receive, is when I say you're going to receive, you say, I'm not among, I will not receive. I don't know whether there are people like that. We are going to tell God, Father, I will be number one to receive your blessings. Help is coming from above. Shout it, I will be number one to receive. In Jesus' name. Beloved, anybody that is connected today will go home smiling. Anybody that is connected, I don't care what you have gone through, and I don't care how long that I've been there, but I'm assuring you from this altar that anybody that is connected is going home with the testimony. I may not do it the way you want, but I'm going to do it the way God wants. And as I do it the way God wants, there'll be testimonies. Father, at this moment, I demand you have your way. When I come into your presence, I'm so happy. When I come into your presence, I'm so glad. In your presence, there is anointing, and your spirit
moves surround me.
In your presence, anointing breaks the yoke. When I come into your presence, I'm so happy. That will come and say, God, I will dance before you today. Number two, the ones that say, God, I'm not perfect. Please perfect me. Show me mercy. The third set of people that will receive before God are the ones that will come and say, I will never leave here as I came. The fourth set of people are the people that will say, oh God, anything that comes out from your servant today, I receive it. And these people must go home with testimonies. Say, God, that is where I belong. And the last one are the ones that say everything, they are ready to return the glory to God. That's the greatest. No one is ever fruitful who is not grateful to God. And I'm talking of fruitfulness today. No one is ever fruitful who is not grateful to God. Quietness everywhere. Father, every one of us is saying that you are faithful. Everyone is saying you are faithful. All of us are saying you are faithful. We are returning all the glory to you. Thank you, Daddy, for everything. See, I know Mela,
Omela, omela ezoma. Si ano meli gwene chendo. Heze Jesus, tuaraya mama. Si ano mela, imela, 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 imela,
imela,
imela,
imela,
imela,
imela.
Akajua si ano mela o. Divided the Red Sea. I am the one that made them to cross the Red Sea. You are the one that turned water into a healing ground. Mighty God, you gave a barren woman children. Father, the hour has come that today help shall come from above. 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 I got you, I see a no mela. Can you clap for Jesus? Father, we are clapping. We are returning the glory to you. We are saying you are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. In Jesus' name. You can have your seat. Something has just started. I'm speaking of help from above. In Psalm 20 from verse 1, the Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. Send thee help from the sanctuary and strengthen thee out of Zion. Remember all thy offerings and accept thy burnt sacrifices. Grant thee according to thy own heart and fulfill all thy counsel. We will rejoice in the salvation, and in the name of our God, we will set up our banners. The Lord fulfill all thy petition. Now know I that the Lord saveth his anointed. He will hear him from his holy heavens with the seven strength of his right hand. Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but our help is from above. We will remember the name of the Lord our God. Our help is from above. They are brought down and are fallen, but we are risen and stand upright. Save, Lord, let the king hear us when we call. Help is coming from above to them. I say help is coming from above to them. When we talk about help from above, I want to concentrate more in the area of fruitfulness, barrenness. When we talk about fruitfulness, fruitfulness covers so many areas. Fruitfulness. The question is, where do you fall in? God takes delight in the fruitfulness of his children. He wants us to be fruitful. The kind of fruitfulness that God is talking about is all encompassing. The kind of fruitfulness talking about, it's not just this one is looking for a child. The kind of fruitfulness is all encompassing. In other words, you are to be fruitful in your body, in your business, in your spiritual life, in everything you do. God expects fruitfulness. There's a kind of open door that is coming to you today that will usher in the fruitfulness. Fruitfulness in all ramifications can be your lot when you are divinely connected, sophisticatedly connected. And I know the fact that I hear this morning, you're already connected. God is telling us that nothing is like impossible or impossibility in his dictionary. That it may be impossible with men, but with God, all things are possible. It may be hard with men, but with God, it is very possible. God, in his divine plan, made a man to be fruitful from the beginning of creation. There are women who had no womb, but today they have children. God is opening doors for people to excel. God is opening doors. And if you connect today, it shall be a portion. Barrenness is going to be a thing of the past. Genesis chapter 1, 26 to 28. And God said, let us make man in our own image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. And God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. It is when you are fruitful that you'll be walking in line with the divine plan of God for your life. When you are fruitful. Deuteronomy 28, 11. And the Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods, in the fruit of the body, and in the fruit of the cattle, and in the land which the Lord swear unto their fathers to give thee. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, the heaven, to give the rain unto thy land in its season, and to bless all the works of thy hand. And thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail. And thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. If thou hearken unto the commandment of the Lord thy God, which I commanded this day to observe and to do them. Now, I have given you a commandment this morning. I've already told you things to do so you don't receive. And I've told you things to do to receive. He gave the commandment then. This is a commandment today. As you follow these things I've told you, no power from the pit of hell can stop your miracle. I said, no power from the pit of hell can stop your miracle. If you believe that, let her amen be loud. Let her amen be very loud. Isaiah chapter 43, verses 18 and 19. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do what? A new thing. Behold, I will do a new thing. It shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Remember ye not the former things. Behold, I will do a new thing. He's not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. He says what he means, and he means what he said. The wilderness and desert referred to in the verse are symbolic of what? Barrenness. Symbolic of what? Barrenness. For God to create rivers and ways in such places means that their type of fruitfulness will be unprecedented. For God to create ways, water, rivers in the wilderness and in the desert means that there is nothing you are going through God cannot change. Absolutely nothing. But now we are talking about fruitfulness. When a woman is pregnant, there is something you cannot do without in the pregnancy. And that has to do with what? The womb. It has to do with the womb. The womb. The subject of fruitfulness cannot be adequately examined without making reference to the significance of the womb. A womb is a place where a seed develops in a fruit. a seed develops in a fruit. Today, there is something special God has decided to do in your life, and no power will stop it. All you need to do is to understand, because everybody here has a womb. Every man here has a womb. Every woman here has a womb. God is about to do something that will touch our lives. Everybody at the reach of my voice has a womb. The womb could mean different things to different people. The womb could mean different things to different people. The womb for a farmer, for instance, is the ground. The ground is the womb for a farmer. The ground is the womb for a farmer. When you see a farmer, he goes to the ground and puts something. What is he believing God for? He believes in God for something better. He has expectation. He's believing God for fruitfulness. The river is the womb for a fisherman. When the river is tampered with, and when your own river is barren, no matter what you do, nothing comes out except you connect to Jesus. And help will come from above. Peter toiled as a professional fisherman. He toiled all night because his water was barren. It doesn't mean there were no fishes in the river. But he toiled all the night but could not catch one. A professional, about the best in his time. He used all the method. He applied everything he knew to catch a fish. He could not, but there were so many fish in the river. He could not catch anyone. But when Jesus came, he said, "It's not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord." When help comes from above, when you trust in him, some can trust in anything. You, Peter, you have trusted so much in your professionalism. You have trusted so much in your net. But I'm going to show you something. Where did you fish last? He said, "Here. I've tried it more than this number of times." He said, "Now, I have come. This is the help from above. I am here now. Cast it the same place." He said, "No, I said, cast it the same place. Every doubt in you today, I command it to leave." The same place he felt, he cast. The Bible said he could not draw the visions. Kayana Mazaka. That's going to be the portion of somebody here. So, barrenness could mean so many things to so many people, to different people. For a student, your brain is your womb. For a student, your brain is your womb. When your brain is tampered with, you become barren. Only Jesus can bring answer. So many people today are barren in one area or the other as a result of activities or the powers of darkness. A church can be barren. A minister's womb can be affected. As a businessman, your shop or your warehouse is your womb. When they want to fight against you, they go there to drop it. As a married man, your home is your womb. When they take battle to your bedroom or take battle to your home, they are tampered with their womb. And something needs to be done. Every area of your life where you've experienced barrenness, today, help shall come from above. Your womb might have been affected, but something is about to come up now. I was in the office this morning. I received a text message. The text message, one of our brothers, I attended the same primary school with him. And those days, anytime they're doing Children's Day, every one of us will be celebrating. We'll be rejoicing. Children's Day, we'll go and crack this palm kernel, sell them and make some money, so we could use it and go for the Children's Day. It's been long. He's now one of the pastors in the church, the Redeemed Church, where Vice President Stephen Joe was pastoring, where he was the pastor. He said that he has used this to preach everywhere, but this morning something came upon him. I've not been talking with him for some time. Primary school. But he sent a text to me this morning, which I showed my wife and Pastor Fanny. He said, "Hope you still remember Bishop, but now see what God has been able to do through you." I want everybody to listen to this text. He said, "As the Children's Day passed by last Friday," this is enough message for everybody. "As the Children's Day passed by last Friday, I could remember very clearly casting back memories back in the days we are growing up. If you could recall, we went to Umuahia Township Stadium for Children's Day. And after our match pass, I was in the company of you and some of our family people, when you price a pair of school sandals for one ridiculous amount like that, and the seller ordered you to remove your school uniform and clean the sandals, and you remove your school uniform and began to clean the sandals because he said he will kill you there. Bishop, you are such a bundle of encouragement to the body of Christ. I am one of the people who can vividly tell your story. God has not finished with you yet. Hear me very well. I went to price school sandals, and they told me about 300 naira. I said 30 kobo. Then 300, I said 30 kobo. The man got angry, opened his chest, I will kill you here. Poor man, you will suffer, continue in this condition. You will never pass this condition. I was shaking. He said, you will suffer. I was small. This was a giant talking to me. He said, you will suffer. You will never make progress. You will suffer in this life. Come and remove your school. White. My school uniform was white. He said, come and remove it. I said, I'm sorry, sir. That's what I have. He said, come and remove it now. I removed. Sir, begin to clean it. I was cleaning sandals. Somebody is still remembering it. He's ready to preach. He said, I'll remain in this condition. But glory be to God, I'm no more in that condition. Glory be to God, I'm no more in that condition. I don't know the condition you are in now. Obakwe bezina na chukwu no so. Obakwe bezina na chukwu no so. Onye na obakwe bezina na chukwu no so. Onye na obakwe bezina na chukwu no so. Origio Rizina Nachukunoso. Oyene Bakwe Bezina Nachukunoso. Oyene Rijo Rizina Nachukunoso. Obakwe Bezina Nachukunoso. Origio Rizina Nachukunoso.
Oh, you are a church, you're a
understand what you are singing. That people are laughing at you. Wait, that God is coming fast. And while he was giving people an example of how God can turn the story of a man, he remembered when he was working with me in primary school. We went for Children's Day, National Stadium, Omaha, Abia State. We got there, and with the palm kernel I cracked. I sold palm kernel, I got the money, little money. I got to a man who was selling sandals. I said, let me change the sandals not to disturb my parents. And I priced, they said 300 naira. I said 30. He said, poor man, you will die in poverty. You will remain in poverty. You will not cross this level. Look at you, small boy. You will remain like this. I was shaking. I will kill you today. I said, please, I don't have much. This one, come on, remove your shirt. I removed white shirt. I iron for Children's Day. White shirt I kept special for Children's Day. I was saying, clean it, the back, everywhere. Even the people that used the tested issue, I was cleaning. My white was turning to brown. I was dirty. Walking in the town, very dirty. I did not come dirty. Somebody made me dirty. Some people that are here today have problems. God did not make them like that, but somebody made them like that. I didn't go to the town dirty, but somebody made me dirty. Somebody forced me because they have power more than me. And they say, I will remain in that condition. But today, God has vindicated me. He has shown me mercy. He has shown me mercy. I am no more in that condition. He has shown me mercy that I can pay for 300 naira sandals. He has shown me mercy that I can calculate what he was selling now and pay him. He has shown me mercy. God is about to show somebody mercy. On you wanna church, Chere, Jehovah, Nadia. On you wanna church, Chere, Jehovah. On you wanna church, Chere, Jehovah.
You are planning your home the way you want it to be, but the enemy at night, so dead. You have gone very neatly to a place, but the enemy painted you black. People have accused you of what you never did. You open your mouth, they say, shut up! Everybody believed that was the deed. And for years, they have believed you did it, but you know you did not do it. Hear me very well. God is about to clean you of every nonsense on your body. Help is coming from above. Help is coming from above. God is about to clean you of every nonsense. God is about to clean you of every nonsense. Help is coming from above. Help is coming from above. I don't care how long you've been in that condition, but the God who showed me mercy is about to show you mercy. The God who showed me mercy is about to show you mercy.
The God who showed me mercy is about to show you mercy. That God will show you mercy today. That God will show you mercy today. That God will show you mercy today. There are people here who are supposed to have married. They are beautiful. They are handsome, men and women. You know, there's a difference between a woman saying, I don't want to marry now until I achieve something. But I'm talking about those who know they are ready, they want it. But everyone they entered into, something will scatter it. There are people who have done traditional marriage, just 10 minutes scattered. There are people who were not parents, but the day of their traditional marriage, people came to dance with them and painted their clothes black. The way I went with the clean clothes and they painted it dirty. That was the way. There are people who, on the day of wedding, in front of the altar, people come to celebrate with them and they begin to do terrible things. There are people who have attended burial, weeping in the course of the burial they attended to. They are there in the burial and they are planning against them and they succeeded against them. But today, the God who cleaned my white shirt, the God who cleaned my white shirt, God who gave me another sandals, that same God is about to visit you at Jesus Christ. Help is coming from above. There are things you remember. You know that the condition you find yourself now is just a phase. You are about crossing it. Whatever you are going through now, it's just a phase. You are about crossing it. There are things that will happen in your life. You call people around you and say, don't worry, this is just a phase. I will testify. It's just a phase. I'm crossing. I will testify. I will testify. I will testify. Hear me very well. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that God that wiped away my tears, that same God will wipe away your tears today. Everyone who has cried in this church this morning, hear me very well. Your tears have gotten to heaven. That same God will wipe away your tears. That same God will wipe away your tears. And he does not just wipe away tears. He wipes away tears with answer. He wipes away tears with result. He wipes away tears with testimony. He wipes away tears with miracle. He wipes away tears with promotion. He wipes away tears with next level. He wipes away tears with unlimited breakthrough. May that be a portion today in Jesus' name. May that be a portion today in Jesus' name. May that be a portion today in Jesus' name. May that be a portion today in Jesus' name. May that be a portion in Jesus' name. God is about to give you something that will rewrite your story. Let it be a portion in the name of Jesus. Let it be a portion in the name of Jesus. Let it be a portion in the name of Jesus. Let it be a portion in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Everything you have lost in your womb, the womb of progress, the womb of breakthrough, the womb of fruitfulness, the womb of marriage, any kind of womb as a student in your brain, any womb of a profession, I command restoration. 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 Your season of change is here. Your season of change is here. Your season of change is here. God is going to change your story. That friends, acquaintances, colleagues, even your enemies, will no longer remember that you are a symbol of poverty before. God will change it. That before they used to use you as a symbol of poverty. But starting from today, they will no longer remember that you used to be a symbol of poverty. I prophesy, they have been dealing with people in your family. They have been dealing with people. Starting from today, their story has changed. That debt they sent to your family. I see a bloodless arm pointing to your home. And that hand has released different kinds of sicknesses. You are not just yourself. You try to be yourself, but you are going through a lot. But that hand, I'm cutting it off now. Everything that belongs to you is coming to you. The same thing is happening to others. They're experiencing similar things in your home. But God says, I have blessed you. Receive your freedom now. Receive it now. There is a woman who was very close to the family and not as close as that now, but still close. That woman used to plait the hair of some members of your family when you were younger. That woman is the one in charge of what is happening to the three of you from the same womb. I prophesy in the name of Jesus Christ, Everything this woman has done in your family, I decree today, resurrection. Yeah. Back to sender. Anything she has planted in this body, I remove. Freedom granted. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree. Oh my God. God has set you free. I decree. They said, how can you? How can you? There is a mark they gave to you against your marriage. They said, this mark will work against you as single and married. It will work against you. But I decree today, that hand is destroyed. I erase that mark. I erase it. Now, settled. Basheka pasokopa. I release everything that will announce you. I release everything that will make you. I release everything, the first four of your requests, the first four of your heart desires. 1, 2, 3, 4, settled. Shaka pasaka. Hear me very well. I prophesy in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, may heaven grant you your heart desires. 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 Some trust in chariots, others in horses. But we remember the name of the Lord your God. I pray for your two legs. I pray for your two legs. Any kind of arrow they want to send in the form of arthritis. Any form of arrow, medically they'll be treated and call it arthritis. But it will be inside, eating deep. I prophesy today, it is canceled. It is canceled. I decree today, receive your grace. Shaka poso kataka. More grace. More unction. More unction. More anointing. More grace. Every hidden gift in this body manifest. Next levels. Shaka pakato kusaka pakata. I prophesy. Divine connection. Zaka pasakataka. Next levels. Capture them. Within the next 2 hours, everything God has planned for you, may that locate you. 1, 2, settled. Oh my God. This name has been mentioned 2 times. But God has mentioned a name severally. But they mentioned the name 2 times. Why mentioning the name in a place that is not meant to be mentioned? By the authority vested upon me by God, thank God that God has mentioned the name more than the 2 times. Therefore, the 2 times is useless. Everything that decree that is coming to your home, out! Back to senders. Now, settle. Is there anything I cannot do? God say, I'm going to cause you to cry all through. You are going to cry my blessings to be so much on you. Every hand, every woman that is beyond your recognition, I prophesy today that you are cut off from every second. Yes, now, as my hand is upon you right now, I decree, receive the hand of God. Receive the touch of God. Blessings. 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 I decree, may God announce you now. Oh yeah? In the name of Jesus, whatever you desire, receive. Shapasoko pakata. In the name of Jesus Christ. The name of Jesus Christ. Multiplication of favor. Sound health. Sound health. Sound health. Sound. I'm hearing the name Ijeoma. This name Ijeoma. God said, when I pray for you, darkness shall be turned to light. Ijeoma. When I pray for you, darkness shall be turned to light. I release grace. Don't come. Just stay where you are. In the name of Jesus Christ, Ijeoma, by the authority vested upon me by God, I make you a testimony. In the name of Jesus Christ, I make you a testimony. Japasoko dakada. Shapakasoko pakata. I decree and I declare by the authority vested upon me by God, in the name of Jesus, receive God's grace. The name of Jesus Christ, Shapasoko takata. May heaven bless you.
May God give you the expectations of your heart. I bring you out of the clay. I place you on the road where God has kept you. I touch the womb of your life. I touch you right now. I decree the power of fruitfulness to flow in. As I count 1, 2, 3, he shall be settled. 1, 2, 3. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He is God. He does not change. The name of Jesus Christ. He is God. He does not change. Thank you, Jesus. Now, it is time for change of stories. Anyhow, you are going to connect. Connect now. Do you want to sit down? Do you want to stand up? Take any position. If you want to sit, you are free. Close your eyes. You want to sit, sit. You want to stand, stand. Be in the mood of prayers. But make sure that any position you are taking, you are connecting. If you can kneel down, kneel down. Any position you want to take now, take. That accident against you is canceled. That accident is canceled. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, it's canceled. As you are sitting or standing, kneeling, I demand for help from above. May Jesus visit you in the name of Jesus. May Jesus visit you in the name of Jesus. May God visit you in the name of Jesus. There is somebody here, you have been planning to come and see me. It's been so difficult for you because you are afraid of what will happen to you. You are afraid. I'm not going to do you anything, please. Run and meet me now that it is there. I don't want you to die. You are so dear to us. You are so dear to us. Don't die. God showed me a picture. You are so dear to us. I was not on this stage when he showed me a picture. I was in the office. He showed me a picture. You went somewhere and they gave you something. That's you are taking it. As you are taking it, you will be able to win something. I don't want to mention that. You will be able to get that. And you started taking that in. And as you are taking that in, you are taking that in. Now, the thing is moving all over your body. What they told you is not what you are seeing now. It's now moving all over your body. Please, make a time and see me. Very important. The thing is now moving, is putting fear in you. It's moving like a creature. You are just feeling it inside of you. Please, come now so we can command that thing to go. You are so important to us. We don't want to lose you. I decree today, in the name of Jesus Christ, that the hand of God that is coming upon you will rewrite a story. They have tormented the child. You seven spirits from the seven waters. You are in the wrong body. You are in the wrong body. They will project things into people around you and be using those things to fight you. Look at an innocent child. Oh yeah, you first snake, out! Second, out. Third, out. Fourth, out. Fifth, out. Sixth, out. Seventh, out. I bind you and I cast the seven of you the same place to outer darkness. Never return again to these bodies and to everyone around and to anyone that knows her. Now freedom is coming your way. You strong covenant against this body. Back! 1, 2, 3. Out! The angels of God had taken her to where they stole her things and kept them. They will return those things. Everything you have lost, the same time these angels are working on her, everything they have stolen from you, they are returning. If God opens your eyes, you see what is happening in the realm of the spirit now. It's just her body that is here. The spirit has gone with the angels to get the things they stole from her. Use your hand. Put on her forehead. Use your own hand. Yes, yes. Your hands are anointed. Put on the leg. Yes. Yes. No, under. Yes. Let it be like that. The fire is increasing in this body right now through your bodies. I increase the fire of cleansing. What the fire is doing now is to cleanse her, because those things have been restored. Those things are back. Those things are, how can you torment a child like this? A child like this. These people are wicked. These people are wicked. Total restoration. Total restoration. Total restoration. Total restoration. Total restoration. Liver, you are free in Jesus' name. Bring her up. Let's clap for Jesus. How are you? How are you? What is my name? Pastor Success. Why are you crying? Eh? You don't know. You don't know. God has set you free. God has set you free. All those strange experiences you're having, God has released and removed what was causing it. So you know me. You know me too well. You are blessed. In Jesus' name. Clap for Jesus, everybody.